Ratnesh Kumar, a little bit of market expert now joining us. Good morning, Ratnesh. Good to have you with us. Crucial days for the market. What are the things you're getting? How much more can we plan?
Well, I think you have to look at this game of the market as one of the things of a bull market, which I think we're still in, and all that it might feel like. In the first phase, you obviously have a lot of hope and expectation which drives the market, which is what we've seen over the last 8-10 months. Then you get into a phase where that rise and that hope and expectation has to be when the market begins to look for actual numbers to support, whether it's not numbers or earnings numbers. And currently we're in that phase, and that verification is not happening. Mm-hmm. And so as a result of that, you have consolidation, you have corrections at times, and to the extent that verification doesn't happen, and in the meantime, you also have other emerging markets actually performing. So those markets which are not performing earlier are attractive funds. And so that's the reason that we are in this phase. But eventually, we will get out of this phase, in a period of time when that verification stamp is there, and then we move to the next phase of the market.
Okay. Ratnesh, hi, I'm here to see you, and as always. So what's the trend you're getting? Has the market bottomed out now, or could it get worse from here?
You can always play around with 5-10% here and there. There are additional factors, frontier factors, global factors, interest rates. You have the additional factor of the NAP issue or for the FIs. So I think we have probably you can say the downside is not more than 5-10%. Is probably how I would look at it. But I would also look at this phase as an internal phase whereby eventually we will get to a situation in a couple of quarters where there will be numbers support, and then at that point the stocks will begin to be too expensive. So this is actually the phase to be constructive in the market, still believing in India's growth story, and moving forward and taking it as an opportunity.
Okay, but are you seeing any green shoots? Couple of quarters, we've heard that before. It's not happening, the earnings are not coming. So is it that we should be able to share in the October-December quarter some kind of improvement? Where would you place the inflection point for earnings?
Well, in reality, it is hard to place. If I would have known, then I would have been a better wisher man. But at the same time, what you are seeing is that indeed the rates will fall further in India. How much? By what time we'll have to see. And the green shoots, the way I look at it, is that you have the problems which were there has stopped to get worse. Mm. What the market will enable to find today are the uptrend signs or the data points. And that will come in the next couple of quarters, whether it's October, December quarter, or somewhere before that. It depends on a few rocks or other variables. Eventually, the investment cycle, the credit cycle, all of those things have to turn around for the market to get the confidence that actually the growth on the basis on which we have had the market run has arrived. Mm-hmm. But it will come. It will eventually come. And at that point of the time, then the market will be talking a different tune. Mm-hmm. So from the investor's point of view, this is the right time to actually be constructive, and be cognizant that in this phase of the market is there will be range bound markets, corrections, etc. And it will not be unduly worried about that.
So what would you be constructive on now?
Well, what you've had in the last couple of quarters is you had a phase where because of lack of growth data points and lot of different segments of the market, the performance and the money flow has focused on areas where those things are visible. Deep pharmaceutical impact, consumers, or different areas where that performance was visible, even IT services sector. I think if I was a 12-month-plus type of outlook investor, then I would look at more economy cyclical sectors like banks or even infrastructure and those areas, because they will take time to turn about, but that's where the value is, and on a regular basis, I think those those segments could actually deliver good returns.
Okay. Just to scratch the point, when you say infrastructure or deep cyclicals, can you be a little more specific? And then would it be capital goods, would it be metal stocks? Which specific infrastructure stocks would you prefer? Many of them have delivered balance sheets in the infrastructure space.
So, to elaborate on these particulars, not commodity particulars, so that
is
where these metals are. I think what I meant were, like capital goods, construction, industrial, banks, cement, these are the sectors where I would focus on. And obviously, certain sectors which continue to deliver decent growth, and you get value opportunities, be it in software or any such area, I think they will continue to remain at the core of the portfolio. But they are also, you may not find deep value there, whereas in the economy situation space is where you can potentially find deep value situations. And with a bit of patience, I think there is returns to be had out there.
What do you think of the mid-caps now, Ratnesh? Because, it seems like there's a lot of precipitation that we've seen, especially from the larger mid-cap names. And it's people are struggling to find value in that space. How do you approach the mid-cap index now?
Mid-caps are, I won't categorize them as one whole category, unlike a sector. And typically, they tend to be individual stories. But as a segment, what also happens is that clearly when the market sentiment is better, they are a leveraged play, so to speak, on the market sentiment. So right now, when the market sentiment is somewhat iffy, you are seeing some correction, some profit taking, but that will remain an attractive space in a recovering economy, in a recovering market on a 6 to 12 month basis. I think mid-cap as a space will remain relevant, and it would eventually come down to stocks, several stories, and stock picking there. And I wouldn't just run away from there just because you have some corrections.
Actually, I refresh you is sending in a lot of flashes on a lot of consumer goods. Symphony is down 10%, Hitachi is down 6%. Voltas, at least a part of it is consumer durable, is down 5%. Whirlpool is down 2%. Consumer durables?
Consumer durables, I think, I will categorize them as the economy certificates. So I'm not really sure what is happening in that space, the stock that you mentioned.
Some of it could be routine profit taking.
Yes.
Anyway, as a space, and it says, have not valuation value.
You had a good run. If you have market X percent return, I think generally the class will add 1.5 or 2X returns. So there would be profit taking, and the profit taking in the class would be more violent in terms of extent of correction. That's natural. And I would just stay very conceptual in the mid-caps. I would stay with individual stock-specific stories. And where the belief is there that is a good story, this correction would be excellent buying opportunities.
I wanted to discuss one space with you that has gotten hit very hard this year, which is the two-wheeler space. So, Real Motor is down 25% this year, the Bajaj Auto is down 20%. Do you expect more downside, or is this a good time to be buying these stocks?
For 2 years, I would at this point stay away or underweight or whatever the rest of the world might be. Simply because I think you have had a financial slowdown and probably there is more to come from the real side. And 2 years, specifically, has the demand which is spread all across the country. And any such large trend of rural income slowdown or consumption slowdown, clearly you've seen these businesses take some time to come back.
So is this correct, a good valuation for companies like Hero Honda and Bajaj and TVS?
Good valuation, I would say, it is not a company-specific concept. It is generally for every stock, where you take into account growth, how much is the growth, how much is the return on equity, what is the cost of equity, and correlate with all of that. So whether that comes to 12 times or 15 times, it depends on each company to company. I would say there is a right valuation.
I was just wondering if in the two-wheelers now there is a valuation compulsion to buy.
Valuation compulsion, sometimes, when you have, you can have ownership of the valuation and ownership of the valuation. So one has to look at the trigger points, and the trigger point for these companies is when the demand they used to bottom out or turn around, I think at that point would be the right time to start looking for value opportunities.
All right, Ratnesh.